celebrated when you was young. See, I remember a lot of things were funny to me growing up in the church. Amen. I thought they were funny. I was with my friends and I was having a good time. I was young. My God, hair was popping. I ain't need no wig then.
I know that's right.
Amen. I had my real hair swinging. My God.
That's right.
I was super fine.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, I wasn't no ugly girl.
Right.
I wasn't no ugly girl.
Amen.
I was turning some heads.
Yes,
amen. Praise God. But I'm going to tell you, all that is vanity.
Come on.
And vexation of the spirit.
Come on,
amen. Praise God. But see, at that time, I couldn't understand that.
That's right.
Even though those who had to rule over me and my parents, they were trying to explain it to me, to the Keisha. They was trying to tell me those things, amen, don't amount to anything. These things will get you in trouble.
Yeah.
Amen. But I didn't want to hear that then. Because I felt like, Mama, you know, you was raised in sin. You had your opportunity to go to the show and to hang out and party and to have a boyfriend. Now, you're going to tell me, you're going to get in this holy thing and you're going to get saved and you're going to tell me I can't do none of this, but you did it.
That's right.
So now I can't do it.
All right.
And you know what? It is hard when a child, when the situation is like that, but sometimes it is. Amen, praise God, because she wasn't raised in holiness.
That's
my
right.
Dad wasn't raised in holiness.
That's
and then
right.
When they tell you about the things they did and how their life was, yeah, the devil played with your mind. And he said, yeah, but they did it, but they don't want you to do it.
Right, right.
You see, but they raising you like this. All your friends out there, you standing out like a sore thumb. Mm-hmm. You the only one at school with a long dress well on. And I was. Mm-hmm. I was, because back then in the 60s, they wasn't wearing no long dresses. You couldn't find no long dresses on the rack. They was wearing scissors and micro mini. So I was standing out like a sore thumb.
Amen.
And I was embarrassed.
Yes.
I was ashamed to get up and go to the bathroom. Because
mm-hmm.
I didn't want people to see me.
Uh-huh.
I was ashamed because I didn't really understand the love of God. But as I grew older, I began to understand what my parents were trying to do, how they were trying to protect me, how they were trying to preserve my life, how they didn't want me to fall into many different situations, because they wanted my life to turn out good. But see, when you're a child, you can't understand that. All you know is what everybody else is doing. See, because you being shaped every day by the world.
Amen.
When you leave your parents' house, and that's why it's important, saints, if you can, to get your children in a Christian school or a school where there are morals.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. It's important that we have schools for our children.
Yes.
Amen. Because when they go and mingle with these people, they begin to, amen, want to take on the character.
Come on. Yes.
They begin to want to take on, they begin to get shaped and molded.
Yes.
The world tells them that this is how it's supposed to be.
Amen.
You're supposed to wear pants. You're supposed to be decked out and have on earrings and fingernail polish. And you're supposed to have a boyfriend.
Yeah.
And they feel like if you don't have it, then you're weird.
Yeah, you're different.
You're different. You're weird. There's something wrong with you.
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with you? How come you don't have a boyfriend? You know why I don't have a boyfriend? Because I don't want a baby at 12 years old.
Amen.
That's why I don't have a boyfriend. So you need to be able to tell them why. When they ask you why don't you have a boyfriend, you ask them why do you have one?
Amen.
What's the point? What is the purpose
right.
of you having a boyfriend? So you can have sex.
Amen. Come out here, sister. Yes.
Amen. Why do you want to have sex at 10 years old?
Come on here.
Because somebody told you it feels good,
uh-huh.
and there's nothing we can do to stop our young people from having. You know why they feel like there's nothing they can do? Because they can't control themselves.
That's what it is.
The grown people can't control themselves.
Amen.
They can't stop having sex. And amen.
Yes.
Come on now.
Amen.
And you know why? Because they're trying to live in this world without God.
Yes.
Right.
When you have God in your life, God will help you to mortify your flesh.
Yes.
He'll tell you how to live holy.
Yes.
People are doing it every day. It can be done.
Yes, it can. Oh, yes.
You don't have to live in this world and have sex
amen.
If you're not married.
Amen.
Amen.
It can be done.
Oh, yes.
But you know what? First of all, you got a woman.
That's right.
Very hard.
Yeah.
If you don't want to eat your broccoli, it seems like the nastiest stuff in the world. Before you even touch your lips, you're ready to throw up. Why? Because I don't want it. Can't get with the smell, the look, it's great. I don't want it.
Right?
Amen. But when you make up in your mind, this is good for me. Amen. It's going to help me to feel better. Amen. It's going to help me to live longer. So regardless of if I want it or not, I got to do it. And when you want to do something, you're going to find a way to do it.
Oh, yeah. Come on now.
And the only way to live free and separated from sin is by coming to God.
All right. That's right.
Amen. Come on now.
Amen. Now, when you hold out on God and say, well, I ain't going to do it, one day it's going to happen. See, we all said that, yeah, one day. You know, there is no day of the week called one day. There's Sunday through Saturday. One day is not in there, and one day never comes.
Never comes.
You will die and go to hell before one day comes.
All right.
That day don't exist.
Come on, come on.
The devil and flesh is going to make sure one day never comes because it don't exist. So just like you planned everything else in your life, mm-hmm, and you got up and did it, when you decided you wanted a car, you start saving.
Yeah.
You start figuring out a way. Well, when my taxes come, I'm getting that car.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to college. Mm-hmm. I'm going